What's up, New York? How y'all doing? I'm out here trying to make a little money, because that's what I do, you know, make money. And I hate people to tell me, Lester, money can't buy you happiness. Now, it's obvious to me that these Negroes don't know where to shop. See, I shop at the BMW dealer. I drove out of there last week with something that strongly resembled happiness, you know? And it smelled like happiness, too, you know? That new smell. And funny thing, when the ladies looked at me, I felt happy, you know? 0 to happiness in about 4.5 seconds. I think you know what I'm talking about. So I can't get on the bandwagon or criticize Michael Jackson. People always talking about him. He's gay, he's freaky, he's playing with animals. Ladies and gentlemen, if Michael Jackson would put me on salary, I'd be one of his animals, all right? Because I got to come up, y'all. I'm living in the ghetto right now. I got to come up and the roaches is bothering me. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I got roaches. I don't mind saying so. I got so many roaches, I got some roaches in my car. Now, you know you got a lot of roaches when some of them got to sleep in the car, y'all. Come on now. But I'm gonna tell you how bad my roaches are. I'm what they call a procrastinator. Now, what that means is that rent to sit on that table in my apartment until the 10th, and then I'll figure out it's time to pay the rent. So this one particular time, it occurs to me, oh my God, today is the 10th. I haven't paid my rent. I go over to the desk, get the money order. The money order's gone, black people. I'm looking all over for the money order. I turn the apartment upside down. I even started a fight with my girl. I said, baby, give me the money order. You know you took that money order. Give me the money order. Yeah. She said, I ain't take your dang money. You know, black woman, I ain't take your money order. And we was about to go to blows, right? Until the big bad roach walked up and said, don't fight. He said he took the rent down to the landlord. Said he didn't want us to get put out, yeah. My own neighborhood, you know what I'm saying? When I come up, I got to be near my people, you know what I'm saying? That's just me, though, you know? And not that I hate white people, if there's any of y'all in here, because I want to be one of the black people amongst all this racial tension to stand up and say that black people should not hate white people. We shouldn't. And I know that every now and again, a black man is going to have a slavery flashback. Now, I know that. Now, I could just be jongling one of my white friends, and they'll say, hey, Les, what do you say we pick up the pace? I ain't picking nothing! Ooh. Oh, it's hot. That jogging suit, it ain't cotton, is it? And white people got all the nice stuff. And not that brothers don't got nice stuff, because we do. But white people don't take care of their stuff like we do. And it's upsetting. I saw a white man on my way here tonight. He was driving a Mercedes. And he was digging in his nose, y'all. Now, I'm looking at him, and I'm thinking, now, where's he gonna put that? I mean, he can't wipe it under the seat because it's a Mercedes, right? I mean, if he was driving like a Pinto or something, it'd be different, right? Now, everybody with a Pinto is mad at me, but we can go outside and do a booger check right now. Take care of your things. Brothers, give it up for the sisters in the house. They looking good. Come on, fellas, give it up. Give it up for them. Give it up for them. That's right. Yeah. You weren't clapping, G. Give it up for the sisters. Okay, give it up for the men, then. Come on, just... Sex and chocolate. Just give it up for somebody, man. I want me a strong black woman, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking for a strong, strong black woman. You know what I'm saying? All the strong black women in the house, say ah. That's right. I didn't really notice the difference between a strong woman and a weak woman until I saw that movie, The Hand That Rocks the Cradle. Now, if you didn't see this movie, I ain't gonna spoil it for you, but in this movie, a woman come into your house, girlfriend. She gonna take your husband and your child away. Now this woman sitting there through the whole movie, why doesn't she just leave us alone? Oh my God. Had that been a sister, that movie would have lasted about 2 minutes. A sister would have said, oh, is that the hand that rocks the cradle? Well, meet the finger that pulls the trigger. I gotta get out of here. I'm Lester Berry. God bless you.